Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I figured it's better I get going with this series sooner or later. So, this is Carrier Command, Gaea Mission, or as I like to call it, the most unnecessary, epically intro music ever. This is basically a strategy, a real-time strategy game where you control a cruiser or a carrier, more like. Apparently I have a game going, so let's restart that. Yes, yes, please, music, calm the hell down. Alright, I think we'll just go with standard settings, actually. Let's have this requirement. No, that's just annoying. Actually, I will just win if I kill the carrier. Fuck, let's go with that. Alright. So, let's go with standard settings and play this game. So, now just a while ago, I played this game actually, so I might be doing stuff stupidly, so I apologize if I suddenly go full retard. We should start out by building some stuff. Oh wait, we have a progress bonuses, so let's have a look at carrier weapons, shall we? Quad guns, yeah, I would like to have lasers and a plasma. We will, of course, need... It's always good to have some fuel. Let's build 10 fuel packs. Alright. So we are currently at this island called Duessa. There we go. Wait, I have a plasma gun? I do have a plasma gun, so we do not need to build a plasma gun. So, remove the plasma. But we don't have any other guns, do we? Nope, we don't. Alright, so we will move over to this island and we will take it. Actually, should we take this first? Nope, we'll take this first. Set sail!
Sir, our arsenal is not strong enough to successfully assault islands as well defended as this one. I recommend attacking weaker islands for now.
Fuck you, mate. I believe we are strong enough. So, our walruses should be... Armor 1, laser, and hack capsule. The first one, on the other hand, should probably just be like that. Yeah. Well, laser RCA resource capsule. Let's do this. We'll take it as program 7. Laser armor. Program 7. 7. 7. And we'll go with 8 for this one. Though not a resource capsule, we'll go instead for a hack capsule, since we'll be capturing an island. And armor, of course. Our Mantis should have lasers, rockets, and flares. I think that's basically, yeah. Let's just set up everyone for one here. Lasers and flares, because that's useful. We'll also give this one rockets and that one rockets. There we go. Now, time warp. I thought that was time warp. That was not time warp. I'm an idiot. Set sail. Time warp. Now, time warp is a little bit weird, because it makes some things go faster, but not everything. And you'll basically have to play the game to learn what goes faster and not. Most things do. Your units will not. You will actually lose control of them in Time Warp, so you should be careful with that. So, this is an enemy island, and we shall start by undocking our Manta and having a scout to see what is on this island. Now we can go up with Q and down with Z. You steer with the mouse and forwards and backwards with W and S. So basically that is it. You can also strafe with the Mantis. Alright, let's have a look around. We have nothing here so far. You can also zoom in with Tab, which changes your FOV basically. Nope. We have a turret. So we switch to rockets. And we kill the tower. No, we missed. Oh shit, we're really low on health actually. So we should probably be careful. And leave!
Shield booster, sir.
Shield booster. Okay. So, every enemy island... Let's see, how did I dock? G. Okay, there we go. Every enemy island has a different kind of... defense, basically. Some have firewalls, so you can't just hack it straight up. Others have shield generators, like this one. So, what that means is basically that... I can't hack the command center on this island until I destroy all the shield boosters, because that's when the shield goes down. So basically you can they're called shield boosters, but I would rather call them shield generators, to be honest. Oh, the graphics are really weird. But it is apparently correct, so whatever. We're getting shot by something that I can't see. Oh, look at that. That's a manta. Oh shit! I accidentally activated my afterburner. Well, I'm actually gonna go home then, because being out there without an afterburner is pretty dumb. So we'll take this one instead. Now, if you do lose your vehicles, like mantas and walruses, it's not the end of the game, because you can just build more of them. But it takes a lot of time, and it's built at your factory island, which means it takes a long time to actually get those resources to you. So try not to lose them unless if you can avoid it. So let's rocket these guys and hope that hit something. It did not. Oh shoot! Yeah, I kind of fucked up there. Sorry. I honestly didn't think they did do that much damage. Let's just get the walruses out, because they're a pretty formidable force this early in the game. And we shall get them down here. How do we get them up here? I thought so. Alright. Now, another manta was placed in slot 2 and refitted. But as you can see, that one does not have flares, because I ran out of flares. This little... Well, the little icon at the bottom of these, can I show this? Yeah, here, this one. There's no flares. Basically means we have no flares in store, so we can't refit this manta with flares. That easy. Now, I'm gonna try a little stealthier approach. Go above this mountain here, zoom in, and try to rocket the walruses out of existence. It's heavily damaged. Hit. I don't think I can reach from here. Nope. Can the laser reach? I think so. Nope. Meter 2, under attack. Doesn't seem to be many defenses right here. So I'll try and... Ow. Damn it! Try and stick close to this mountain here. And... Ah! There we go. Now, if you're close enough, your lasers and missiles and stuff will auto-target, and I'm almost dying. So let's leave. Hopefully I won't fly. Won't fly into another defense. No, I'm fine. Okay. So we'll just get out of dodge. And return to the carrier. We'll switch to the walruses. That are now... Wow, why is... Walrus 9 up there all alone. What the balls? Dude. You need help. Alright. Don't go solo, okay? No solo YOLO here. Alright. Now, I can tell all the walruses to basically support this one by right-clicking on it, I thought. No, that's Doc. That's not what I wanted! Man, if I could remember how to do this, I would be so... There you go. Shift. Shift was the key. Alright, so now they support this one, which means I can control one of them and have the others following, going on AI. Now, the AI is pretty darn brain dead, So don't count on your walruses being as awesome as you are. As you can see, right now, they have trouble figuring out how the hell to get down here because there's three of them, so their pathfinding keeps bumping into each other. So sometimes you have to have some patience with your AI units. They're not amazing, but they're not bad either. They have pretty good aim and they have rather good idea on what to focus and what to ignore, so you can still trust them. And yes, that sun is just as annoying as it looks. Wow, you were injured. There we go. Laser front left created. Awesome. Now, troops, while doing a lot of damage, they are really easy to kill, especially with a laser. But even with machine guns, they're stupidly easy to get. Now, Mantis can be a problem, because they tend to have a lot of health and sometimes rockets, but this one was apparently easy to kill, so we're fine. That was a rocket launcher, and apparently did zero damage. Alright, nice. Now, this here, I think, let's have a look, where are we? Number 8, you're lost. Now this is a walrus garage, which means walruses will spawn from here to fight you. So if we simply laser this, I have to stop the laser before it overheats. Now if we laser this out of existence, unfortunately the slight problem is that the laser is really, really freaking inefficient at taking out buildings. See? There's a walrus. Will you, please? Thank you. Alright, 7. Right, you're under AI control. La-di-da-di-da-la-di-da-da. Overheated. Apparently, this is taking a really long time, but there you go. Walrus is low on ammo, yeah, I know. Apparently my carrier is being attacked by something. It's not ideal. It's probably Mantis coming from the island and moving up to attack the carrier. Now the carrier can defend itself, especially if you have... I'm sorry? Did I tip that over? Oops. Especially if you equip it with multiple weapons. That looked like a Manta. So there's probably a Manta over here. No? Didn't see it. Alright, whatever. Alright. Yeah, there it is. Hi. Get into range so I can melt your face. Ah! I can't aim that high. Bro! There you go. Alright, I'm really starting to run out of ammo on this guy. So I'll just form a front line here and we'll have the other guys do their thing. Alright, all of you retarded walruses, can you please get up here? Yeah, I'm under attack by Mantis. So, we'll undock one of our own Mantis. But as you can see, I'm not taking a lot of damage, and the plasma cannon is firing on its own. But the plasma cannon is absolutely ridiculously bad at taking up Mantis. Though, do keep in mind that... the plasma cannon can kill you. If you get hit by a shot from the carrier, your own carrier, just a stray shot, you will die. So, try not to stay between the enemy and the carrier. Now the laser does a lot more damage than the machine gun does, so you easily win over machine gun walrus with yours, especially if you, like me, have armor level 1. But don't underestimate it. It still does damage. So, now that everyone's here, Alia, in here, and destroy that one. Then destroy that one, Samantha Garage. Now, if I'm not wrong, they should Nope. Yeah, there they go. Now the problem is, we're gonna run out of ammo, so I'm gonna send this guy home. And instead have this guy help destroy that thing. Oh, wait, they're still supporting him. Guys, stop! Stop! Okay, number 6, go home. 8, 7, 8, 9, attack that. There we go. 6, go home. You 3, kill that. Focus! And as you can see, if you just give them orders, they do just fine. But sometimes you have to micromanage a bit, and that is kind of what separates this from most other RTSs, that there is a fair bit of micromanagement. You can't just send your units and expect them to do everything for you. That just doesn't happen. There we go, we'll send them there, and I'm gonna have another scouting trip with the Manta. Now, the Mantas you should always fly yourself. Very rarely do I send out Mantas on their own or in squadrons, especially if there's defenses around, because they are really bad at dodging missiles and cannons and whatnot. And now we have a sandstorm, how annoying. But if you have walruses already on the ground in an area, you can always send the Mantas to support them. That is not a bad idea. No defenses? Or is it just my sensors? Yeah, my sensors are just not picking them up. Because freaking sandstorm. There we go. Alright, now, I have rockets on this Mantis, so destroying this shield generator will be really easy. Here we go. Do we have anything important here? No, we do not. So let's go there and help. And now, when I'm giving it orders, I can still be in it and see what it does. You know, see from its perspective, so to speak. But just be mindful that as soon as you touch anything... Oh, okay, never mind. As soon as you touch anything, it will go back to manual control. So 6, go home. 7, go home. 8, go home. 9, go home. 2... go home, 3, undock, and we'll use you for scouting. Now, I always use armor on my walruses, because they are already very slow, and they tend to take a lot of punishment on enemy islands, because they come up on turrets and stuff first. They fight the other walruses, and they fight the other mantas and all that stuff. So I always keep armor on my walruses, but mantas... they kind of rely on their mobility, so I tend to avoid having armor on them. Unless they need out armor to mount a specific type of weapon. Alright, so we have a couple of walruses here. Let's see if I can melt it while keeping the others behind this building here. Dude, you're in my... oh shit. That is a Manta Manta garage that we need to kill, or Manta hangar that we need to kill. Alright, got it. Let's see, was there another walrus, or was that a person? That was a person. Die. Dude, melt. Alright, now we kill this, so they can't spawn mantas. There we go. And then we go home, because we took about half health damage. As you can see, the mantas are really squishy, so you should be careful using them. Let's have a look. Now, you guys, I told you to go home. As you can see, they are sometimes really retarded, so what you can do is just take one of them and drive it out of the base. Okay, it's not just them that are retarded, it's me. Okay, so the exit is over here. Wait, where the hell am I? How do we get out of here? Oh! Oh, okay. Now I can see why they're not finding their way out. There is no easy to find road. What is that yellow thing? Oh, hi. You're dead. There, now I can send him home. And then select number 7 that doesn't know where he is. And just follow the tracks of number 6. And send him home too. So as you can see, the pathfinding is the big problem with this game, and you really need to keep that in mind when you send your units around, and always keep an eye on the map to make sure units are getting where they're supposed to be going.